I spent the whole day out in the humidity. It did have a short rain period, so just imagine short, hot, steamy. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we have a wear test, and not just any wear test, boo. It's a wear test that you guys are always looking for, asking about. I get messages on messages. I'm quite excited because a lot of you want to know what my shade is in this formulation, and this foundation comes in 50 shades, so there are quite a bit of options. But without further ado, I want to announce our partner for today's video, the sponsor, the supporter, the brand helping us keep the lights on for today, Lancome. We will be testing their Tante Idole Ultra Wear Foundation with SPF 15. This is a full coverage foundation, as mentioned, 50 shades. Let's put the shade range on the screen. Retails for $47, has a natural matte finish, and is basically life-proof. It is transfer resistant. It is long wear, for real, for real. Wins so many awards. Everyone loves it. A lot of people swear by it. It's their end all be all daily go-to, if you know what I mean. I have tried this when I was younger, probably closer to when I was leaving high school, so about a decade ago, and I couldn't find a match back then. But I also didn't know what I was doing back then as much as I do now. You know, with age comes experience. So being that I believe there are more shades now, and also I have a little bit more skill, I think we can find something for me and my twinsies, and if not, at least a good reference point for everybody. So out of the 50 shades, I have two. I have 330N and 340N to show you guys today. So let me get them swatched. And one of the best parts about today is that I actually have somewhere to go. So it's nice to get glam and actually be seen, if you know what I mean. We have a family outdoor picnic in 90 degree weather, humid. It might also rain today. There's a lot going on, and I need a foundation that's gonna go with me on this adventure, basically. Here we are with shades, 330 being on this side and 340 being on this side. So this is 330N, and if you look at the swatches, I actually think that they look a little darker than when first applied. So I believe since it's more of a matter formula, it's gonna set a little darker on us. So we're gonna give it a moment before we make our decision. And this is 340N. As you can see, both look so light, but I doubt it will in a few seconds. I know a few of you are wondering, why did you pick neutrals? You are a yellow undertone gal, I know, for those who watch. If you're new here, for the most part, I am pretty yellow, but as I get tanner in the summer months, I am in intro shades of summer. Like, I would classify myself more summer than winter right now. I get a little bit more neutrally, but neutral is different in every line, as well as warm is different in every line. Like, warm is not always yellow, and neutral is not always peach, depending on the brand you're looking at and the product itself. As you can see, it's setting. You can see more of the tones. So both of these are neutral, but I believe 330 looks a little bit more peachy on me, while 340 looks a little bit more like neutral beige, a little hint of yellow. The neighboring yellow shade, so the next one up, would be 370 and 380W. Both of those claim to be warm yellows. The swatches definitely look yellow. But when I had these little sample packets, you know, like things that you get with your orders, this foundation in 370 was a little too dark for me when I was looking at it. So that's why I went a little bit lighter. I think I'd be closer to just around the like 300 flats in winter, like at my lightest. So I'd range between the 300 to the 370s, depending on time of year. Between these two shades, I think we will go 340 because she looks a little bit more promising. Though it's natural matte, it's still on the matter side, so I want to re-moisturize my face. That's all I have on right now. I don't have any eyes or brows on. This is the Summer Fridays Cloud Dew. It's a moisturizer I am testing. It's new, but a really nice lightweight gel that has more of a cream finish, so it gives enough moisture for these warmer months. At least off my first impressions. I wanted to test this formulation without a primer because it's optional according to the brand, and I also hear so many good things about it that I don't want a primer to mess with its long wear abilities. I know, like, that sounds crazy, but it could happen. So I want to use a sponge. Sponge is my preference. I do remember, because of the coverage from a long time ago, a brush piles it on a lot faster, but it blends okay with both. I would rather just pat it on using a medium-sized sponge. This is from ColourPop. To really give it a chance to sink into that skin well. I'm actually working fairly quickly, but just in smaller sections like the chin, the forehead, because it does set at a reasonably faster speed. Not too fast, it's still workable, but let's say you know, dabbed it along your face, you'd want to buff faster. But working a section at a time, not an issue. As you can see, very seamless, looking really good. Whatever's left is gonna go across the eyelid. And of course into the hairline, and we're gonna go down the neck. So that's just one thin layer, and I feel like it still looks like me, myself, and I skin tone wise, but way more finished, you know, less scarring, less all that going on, less discoloration, all the craziness. The top of my shoulder is very, very tan, even compared to like the center of my body. So we'll glance at it after we're all done, like before some bronzer possibly, because you know, I love my bronze, especially in the month of June. Bronze is not letting me down, but here's a little before and a little after before we even her out. As you can see, this goes on a lot lighter. As mentioned, it's gonna dry a little darker. I don't know if that's because of the SPF 15. This is a chemical sunscreen, so it could just take a second to settle. And if anything, you might see just a difference in color via camera versus in real life. That was actually way more than I needed. I'm actually gonna add just the smallest amount of color correction. I wanna show you the coverage without any. I have a weird pattern of scarring right here on my cheekbone and it kinda interferes with my contouring later on. So I'm using the NARS color corrector, their new one. I reviewed it recently. And just putting that on that area only. You can do this before and after. I've done it with this formula. Both ways works perfectly fine. And just pat it on in. And basically just work on the edges. It just helps with the undertone of that like grayish whatever depth that my acne scars give me there. Whatever's left on my sponge, I will put right here, which is also an acne scar, but for the most part, she's kind of already gone. I am going quite light with application pressure and amount around my mouth and my nose, just because those are my more textured areas and it's a high coverage formula. So less is more when those areas come up. But I can see right now, just from our one layer, I think that's all we need, why so many people love this formula. It's smooth, girl. It's smooth. I thought it was heavy the first time I tried it back in the day. I mean, 18-year-old me probably wasn't making great decisions anywho, you know? So this doesn't feel heavy. It actually feels quite light. Granted, I used a sponge in one layer. So if you use a brush and a thick couple layers, anything will feel differently. But for the most part, I'm quite happy with how it looks already. It has a little bit of a reflex for something that is natural matte. It's not cakey. It's still reflecting the light, still looking a little hydrated without looking dewy. If you're interested in trying the Tante Idole Foundation by Lancome for yourself, they are available in all 50 shades at Ulta. So you can go to ulta.com, which I'll have linked off down below, or check out your Ulta Beauty stores. A little birdie told me, I saw, you know, on social media, that there's gonna be a concealer, a pairable, you know, sister product, a Tante Idole concealer coming out in July. So if you're interested in seeing me review that, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and I will definitely do it for you. For under eye concealer, we're gonna use a little combo. First thing we're gonna use is the Fenty Beauty Butter Bright Fix. I have this on my desk, might as well get a little, you know, brightness under these eyes. As I said, we're gonna be seen today, guys. So we want to look nice and shaped, dimension, awake. Now that we have this on our highlighted areas, basically down the center and under the eyes, kind of going up in a little angle, we're gonna add our second product, very, very small amounts of the Armani Beauty Luminous Silk Concealer. This is in 5.75, and I'm putting that just where I need a little bit more coverage. This is a hydrating formula, so it plays pretty nicely for the most part if you haven't powdered yet. And I don't think we're gonna be using a lot of powder aside from our cheek products. I'm adding just a little bit where it's needed. Because you can wear the Bright Fix by Fenty by itself if you would like to, or you can pair it as a corrector. And I blend this outwards, and then for the inner corner, I kind of blend into this little nook a little bit because I have a little bit of a shadow, a little eye crevice cave situation where it has a little bit of darkness. So I'm pressing in and just kind of patting around. Now that we have highlighted, I'm sure the actual base itself looks a little light, which I'm not saying it's not, because as you can see, like, I do have more bronziness in my skin from beach trip number one. I still have two more beach trips this summer with the kiddos. So she's gonna get even more summery. The solution would be bronzer, baby. So I'm trying this new contour powder. It's technically not a bronzer, it's a contour powder, but this is contour number 6 from KKW Beauty. I think we're gonna be using her for the cheeks, a little bit maybe for the lips. We'll see. Getting a big old brush and just tapping. So we're gonna pat this along our hairline, our cheekbones, and of course our jawline. And I'll probably put this on the side of my nose as well. Make sure I just press this in. This powder is actually new. I haven't used it prior to today. Brand spanking new. I've used the contour sticks, but the powders were always sold out when they first released a couple years ago, and I just never revisited the idea. But if anything, Kim knows her new lipsticks, and she knows some good shape and dimension to the face. This is a really nice undertone. I like it. Bronzing is so much easier for me in the summer versus winter because, I don't know, my body undertone, like, it goes with it well, you know? So I bring my bronzer a little bit down here right now. I know it's looking a little crazy. Don't worry. It's gonna get better. We haven't finished. Trust the process, boo. This looks so intense because we haven't blended it out yet, but I don't have my brows on yet either. Typically, I do when we start a video, so that's gonna blend really nicely into the front of the brows in a sec. The good part about not having my eyes done yet, I can use bigger brushes to blend out the nose contour without worrying about hitting something I shouldn't be hitting, like my brows. I get really nice and seamless right now. A little shape, a little snatch. I can see the potential already. Now that that's on, I want to hop into some KKW Beauty loose powder. This is the number 2 bake, not my color. I've mentioned it before. It's a little too pink for me, but we gonna use her anyway because we've already paid for her and she's been around for a bit. I also made a huge mess with this product. Like, there's no cover. I took the whole sticker off years ago. Big mistake. Quite messy. I'm packing that along the sides of the nose, and then I'm putting a smaller amount just on the under eye concealer area. I'm not really letting that sit out unblended. We're just gonna pat in like that. And I know I always say this powder isn't right for me, but it's because I like yellows. It still works fine, especially right now we're wearing more, you know, neutral tones versus very, very yellow. We're putting this between the brows and on the chin. This is the hard part, down the nose. See if I can use this little corner. That's as good as it's gonna get, probably, guys. We're gonna apply our blush while we're letting this sit, and after our highlight, we'll come back to her. So for blush, you guessed it, KKW Beauty. This is also new. It kind of reminds me of MAC Melba. If you were Melba gang, you know. Melba was my go-to in high school, and I'm pretty sure still a bestseller with MAC. It's kind of like a peachy coral in a way that's matte. But this is called Honey Love. It's one of the two honey blushes, thus this different colored packaging, which, feeling the vibe, love it. Using a very similar brush like the one we used for our bronzer contour, but just a smaller one. Here we go. Ooh, that's really pretty. It's kind of helping us blend out our top of our bronzer contour. Just padding a little bit at a time. I have a feeling this is super pigmented, and, you know, blush is easy to get carried away with, especially me, myself, and I. Almost using this kind of like a transition shade in a way. Oh wow, we look Grabbing just a little bit of powder to kind of clean up this non-bronzed area. Very, very light amount. We don't have it too bright. I know some people look really good with that area super bright. I don't. So last but not least, for the base, we're gonna highlight. You saw me use this recently. When I get new things, I get kind of stuck to them. This is the Melt Cosmetics Stargazer. Okay, okay, imprint, okay, design with a fan brush. She is a soft champagne. So if you have a soft champagne, help yourself. We're not gonna go too crazy. We'll bring a little bit more back to this area. I'll put it a little bit towards the brows, but of course the eyes aren't done yet, but you'll see how it all comes together. Just kind of going where the light tends to reflect. Chin, so just very lightly down the center. I feel like a fan brush is more accurate, but you also have to have like the lightest little hand when you're doing the nose bridge. Blessing it, blessing the bridge. All right, we're looking snatched, smooth, ready for some brows, eyes, all of the above, right? We need some lips and some lashes too, so I will be right back. Give me a sec. So we're back with our brows, eyes, cheeks, lips, full face complete. This is our starting point. I think we're looking snatched, shaped, sleek, elite, all of the above. Hopefully I can hold up to the heat and humidity though. That's that's my main concern, but for the most part, we got that coverage. Looking really smooth. I'm impressed. So I'm gonna give you starting point pictures, close-up cam footage, and then make sure you stay tuned to the end of my day to see if I'm still in one piece. It's 8:48 at night. We're back. And for the most part, I would say we're in one piece. Let's get into the pictures and the close-up cam footage so you guys can decide for yourself. I think the color is looking great on us. I spent the whole day out in the humidity. It did have a short rain period, so just imagine short, hot, steamy. That's the environment I was in. I was absolutely, for sure, without a doubt, sweating in this formulation. So sweat-proof it is. Very happy with that. I have not poured any water on or anything, but I don't think it claims to be waterproof. Transfer proof, yes, and we can check that because I am wearing a black t-shirt, so I'm gonna pick an area that doesn't have contour. Wasn't actually bad at all. Okay, hold on. Let's try the forehead. Pretty good. I mean, I could do a little rub, I guess, a little rub. It's a little minor transfer there. It could be, you know, just a little bit like when you rub it, but it isn't as strong as yesterday. Yesterday I wore a white shirt. And when I tell you it had a collar, and you know how I blend my foundation out, girl, I was like setting it with a million things. I still had just a little bit of residual. So it's fairly transfer resistant, not transfer proof. And I think it did in verbatim say resistant. So I will absolutely give it that. I love the shade with the bronzer, as mentioned. Like I will sign off on this. It is a like such a minorly like amount, a little light for me right now, just a little bit, but it's not to me that noticeable at all. A few more swipes of bronzer and it's exactly perfect. I would wear it exactly how it is shown right now, again, no problem. I really like how it's looking. Like this is absolutely an A to me. Not an A plus, but an A. I'll give it that. There's a little more yellow. And if I wasn't shiny on my nose is a bit shiny. We did not do extra powder because I already did, you know, the loose powder on the nose, the bronzer, like the nose itself got powder. So I didn't powder more on top of that. And for the other areas of the face that, you know, maybe didn't get extra attention, it still looks great. So I don't have any complaints. It's super smooth. I don't think it's lightweight to the point that I forgot I'm wearing makeup. I absolutely know I'm wearing makeup, but I don't feel like I'm wearing something with this much coverage. So a little bit more than a tinted moisturizer and feeling, but not to the point that I feel like I'm wearing like a thick cream full coverage situation. For my texture areas, of course, anything that has heavier coverage, it's not gonna look like it's not there at all, but it's not cakey. And I think it, for the most part, moves well. Like, I'm smiling, and I don't feel like it's excessive in the, you know, like, the tugging. You know, some formulations just look like, oh, that thing doesn't move. This has a little flex to it, and I like that. So that also helps in those textured areas, but it's probably not, like, the best of the best performance, but it's not bad. Like, it could be peeling, chunky, gross, dry, it's none of the above, and that's why it can still get an A. For $47, it's not a cheap foundation, but there's so many shades, and its performance definitely holds up, especially to weather elements. So I know a lot of people daily this. I know a lot of people use this for their special occasions. I see why. I understand. I don't know what I would wear in the winter shade wise. I'm glancing at the shade range and I would assume it'd be maybe 300 would maybe be me at my palest. That looks a little yellow. That looks a little light. Maybe 300, 310, one of those. If you are a twinsie, you can definitely drop that info down below. If you guys made it to this point in the video, make sure you drop. Let's do a flower emoji just because there's a flower at the top of this packaging. If there's a rose, let's do the rose emoji. I'm actually not sure, but if there's a rose, we'll do a rose. I think that's it for us today, guys. I gotta let you go before my lash lets me go. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you guys for spending a part of your day with me. If you would like to spend a little bit more time, I'll put my recent uploads on the screen right here, as well as the subscribe button. So if you haven't subscribed yet, feel free to click this button and join our fam. I would absolutely appreciate if you do, as well as use my links down below if you would like to shop anything shown in this video, especially our Lancome Tante Idole foundation. If you want to check out any of the 50 shades at Ulta or Ulta Beauty stores, info all down below, everything you need. That is it for me today. I will see you guys in a later video.